You saw the story first, right here on KOAT, a bombshell from one of New Mexico's top politicians.
Senator Pete Domenici will not seek re-election, and this morning we're covering the story from all angles. We start our coverage from our exclusive Washington Bureau, where Nicole Killian is standing by with more. Good morning, Nicole.
Yeah, good morning to you, Christina and Marissa. And that formal announcement will come later today in New Mexico that Senator Pete Domenici is set to retire at the end of his term next year. Now, Domenici is a long-term power player and Republican voice on budget issues. He is retiring because of health reasons. He's expected to talk about how he suffers from a degenerative brain disease. The senator is 75 years old, but he says right now he's confident with his ability to serve out the remainder of his term. Domenici is at least the fourth Republican senator not seeking a new term, so Democrats see this as an opportunity.
Voters are going to have a great opportunity to evaluate some tremendous candidates, and I think we'll have a powerhouse come out of that June primary.
And other Republican senators stepping down next year include Virginia's Senator John Warner, Nebraska's Chuck Hagel, and Wayne Allard of Colorado. Christine?
Nicole, we're already hearing talk about the 2008 race. How confident are Democrats about taking over some of those seats that you were mentioning?
Well, you know, all of these seats are going to be very competitive. And as for New Mexico specifically, you might recall in the last presidential race, President Bush only carried the state by one percentage point over Senator John Kerry. So, again, this is going to be a close race to watch indeed, Christine.
Okay, Nicole, thank you so much. Senator Pete Domenici served six terms in the Senate. He's currently the top Republican on the Energy Committee.
And Senator Domenici grew up right here in the Duke City, and it's where he started his political career.
This afternoon, his career will come full circle as Domenici announces his plans formally at a school he once called home. Action 7 News reporter A.J. Smith is live in downtown Albuquerque with more. Good morning, A.J.
Well, good morning, guys. Today, Senator Pete Domenici will be here in downtown Albuquerque at his alma mater, St. Mary's Catholic School, near the courthouse that bears his name, to confirm that he will not seek re-election. Senator Domenici has come a long way since he grew up in the Duke City. He has been a power broker in the state of New Mexico for more than 35 years. He won six terms to the Senate, each time with lots of support, but his last victory in 2002 was just that, his last. The son of Italian immigrants, Domenici graduated from UNM in 1954. He got a law degree from the University of Denver in 1958 and opened a law practice. He held the position equivalent to Albuquerque's mayor back in 1968, then became New Mexico's U.S. Senator in 1972. Earlier this year, the president came to town to help raise money for Domenici's seventh run for Senate. A Domenici advisor told the Associated Press that lingering concerns about his health are the main reason for his decision. The advisor denied that political problems for Republicans in general, and Domenici in particular, are behind the announcement.
It's the right thing for him to do. You know, the rule of law means that everyone is under the rule of law, including senior senators.
Now, some point to the controversy surrounding the firing of U.S. Attorney David Iglesias as a motivation for Domenici calling it a career. Iglesias claims that Domenici tried to pressure him into indicting Democrats before last fall's election. It's a claim that Domenici denies. And, of course, you can count on KOAT to stay with this story as it develops throughout the day. Reporting live here in downtown Albuquerque, A.J. Smith, KOAT Action 7 News, live this morning.
Thank you.